Welcome back, everybody. Today we're heading back to Universal Orlando. It's the opening day for their holiday stuff. We'll check out Grinchmas and see Whoville. We'll get to see the parade later and see what kind of other fun stuff they have in store for this holiday season in 2024. So come hang out. All the booths in City Walk are decorated for the holidays as we make our way over to Islands of Adventure. We'll head to Islands first today and then go over to Universal Studios Orlando for the parade and festivities later on this afternoon. Head over towards Circus McGurkus and One Fish Two Fish. That's the entrance to where the Grinchmas Holiday Spectacular is. There are show times throughout the day. We'll probably end up seeing that another day. I don't think we're going to have enough time to see that and head over to get good spots for the parade because the next show is at 3:30. But that's where the entrance is for the attraction. Love a quiet day at Universal.
For your safety, remain seated at all times. Keep your hands and feet inside the vehicle. Supervise children. Hold on to lap restraints at all times. Ensure everyone has their own seat.
To the fish in the pot?
They should not fly kites in a house. They should not!
Is all decorated for Christmas too. striped red and silver Christmas trees, and then the cat in the middle is covered in garland as well.
Looks like they have new ice pops at Circus McGurkus as well. There's a blue lemonade and a cookies and cream. They're shaped ones of Horton and atrocious ice pop, whatever that is. It's kind of like the Shrek and Donkey ones over in DreamWorks Land. It looks like you can order them, or you can probably get them inside as well.
Looks like some of the Who's of Whoville are out and about in Zeus Landing. They usually make appearances in between show times. If you're looking to just meet the Grinch, he's down at the other end of Zeus Landing, kind of on almost the Lost Continent. He is very popular. It is a 150-minute wait. It looks like they might be using a virtual queue system, and then you would come back and still get in a line that could be at least an hour. I believe he usually starts meeting around 11 a.m. So you can get in line as early as the park opening if you want to wait those 2 hours until he officially starts, and maybe be one of the first ones in the line, that's fine. But that's really the only way of meeting the Grinch, other than buying the breakfast with the Grinch, which is about $60 a person, an adult. There are pass holder discounts if you do have an annual pass. That guarantees you get to meet the Grinch, take photos with the Grinch. You also get to meet a few of the other Seuss characters, and the Who's are usually in there as well. It takes place in Circus McGurkus, where we just had lunch. So in my opinion, if you really want to meet the Grinch, book breakfast with the Grinch. It's a full buffet breakfast. You are guaranteed to meet him. You don't have to wait in a line. You can eat while you wait for him to come around to your table, kind of like all the other character dining is at Disney and at Universal. And that way it kind of guarantees you getting to see him. He's also in the show, but of course you can't meet him after the show or anything. So the easiest way of getting to meet the Grinch is at the breakfast. If you do want to not do the breakfast, spend the money on the breakfast, like I said, you are more than welcome to come to Zeus Landing early, as early as you want, and get in line or get in the virtual line, depending on if they're using it or not, and kind of go from there. We are going to head over to Universal Orlando now to see the holiday festivities over there. I know they do like little shows and meet and greets with characters from Madagascar and Santa and dancers and stuff throughout the streets, especially over by the big tree in front of the tribute store, before the parade steps off at 5:30, and we'll check that out as well. Looks like you got a big inflatable Macy's balloon that'll be walking through the park depending on the weather and wind, really. And then you have the medallion that just got put up overnight last night. If you were lucky enough to see them open up the queue for the meet and greets with Elphaba and Glinda, apparently they're still doing them throughout the day, but it's at random and they don't know when it's going to happen. The line opened up and within 30 seconds it was completely full and closed up for the day. you make your way over to the big tree in front of the tribute store in Macy's. You look very carefully. You might find Earl the squirrel somewhere hiding in this tree. There's a hole right in the middle of the tree. I bet you he pops out of there or he's at a different spot. Well, we'll try and find him. Like after the little show the toys do, they come over here to the side street where the Ghostbuster food booths were, and they do a meet and greet with guests over here as well. And then after that is going to be Madagascar and Alex the Lion.
And it's my pleasure to welcome you to the E.T. adventure. But I'm afraid we don't have much time, so I'm going to cut right to the chase. E.T. needs your help. Now, I've just received an urgent message from E.T.'s teacher, Botanicus, calling for E.T. to come home right away. You see, a big problem has developed 3 million light years away on E.T.'s home world, the Green Planet. E.T.'s friends are in danger because their planet is dying. Remember what E.T.'s friends look like, because it's going to be up to you to help E.T. find them once we get him home. And there's not a moment to lose, because only E.T.'s magic healing touch can save his friends and bring his planet back to health. E.T. must go home, and only you can help him. Ah, E.T.
Trouble.
That's right, E.T. So why don't you show these people how we're going to get you back to the Green Planet? You and E.T. will be making your 3 million light year journey on these bikes, but don't worry, you don't have to pedal. But you will need an interplanetary passport. So before you leave with E.T., tell your first name to one of our assistants, and they'll give you your pass.
Oh.
Sounds like E.T.'s ready to go. So good luck, everyone. And remember, E.T.'s counting on you, and so am I.
Oh.
It's up to you to save his planet so that he may visit us again.
They added new LED lights in here. The forest looks much brighter than it normally is, so I wonder if these are all new lighting in the queue for E.T. Inside the E.T. queue are these bunnies. There's one here, and there's one above the entrance to the left of the express line. And there's also two owls hidden in the trees that are animatronics as well.
Earth people, our planet is dying. Find the one you call E.T. Bring him home to the Green Planet. His friend, deeply moved, needs a healing touch.
Hey,
Yep. All the creatures of the green planet are in one ring. A planet's life force is
start heading over to
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. The tidings we bring to you and your kin. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Now bring us some figgy pudding. Now bring us some figgy pudding. Now bring us some figgy pudding and bring it out here. The tidings we bring to you and your kin.
Delivery. special time of the year! With rat pies and stink bugs, roadkill and worm grubs, and wax for my ear! It's the most delicious time of the year!
So thanks for joining us today at Universal Orlando Resort, checking out just a fraction of the holiday offerings this year. If you do like these videos, please subscribe to our channel. We love what we do. We love posting these videos and sharing our amazing parks here in Central Florida with y'all. Any support we can get is greatly appreciated. But until next time, we'll see you then.